Hi, y'all. It's Lindsay Ali here with Team Make It, and this is our weekly team call. It is April 26, 2016. It's a Tuesday, and I'm recording this early, actually, because we have very severe impending weather here in the DFW area. So, I don't know what, you know, the internet is supposed to be really bad. I don't know what the internet may do to us, so I'm recording in case we cannot do our call later tonight. But I am super excited about this information because I know that it's something that I really need to learn how to do and grow. I do have my little one in my lap, so he's going to talk with me. But I do want to share with you why people follow and unfollow us on social media and how we can grow our pages, because this is something that I really need to do and work on. And I want to be able to share what I'm learning and researching myself to, so that you can work on it too. Now, I'm just getting all of this information. It is nothing that I have come up with. It is all from other people that I have listened to and read, people like Facebook guru Mary Smith and Christine Dwyer. She did a call on this, and I just want to pass it down the lines to my team. So please get a pen and paper and write this stuff down, because I think that it's really important for us to try to learn how to grow our social media accounts. So, first thing that was talked about in one of the podcasts that I listened to, and I'm so sorry, now he's going to throw a fit on us, was why people unfollow us. One thing that they pointed out was that there are fake accounts out there. So if you noticed a big burst of unfollows, that you dropped a lot in likes all of a sudden during a short period of time, that Facebook is going in and deactivating all of those fake accounts, and they have started follow you. So that may be one reason. But the number, that was like a bonus for us. But the number one reason that people unfollow, according to the podcast and the articles that I've been reading, is that we post too much self-promotion, or we're boring. Like we're saying, hey, look at me, look at me, and we post too many selfies, or you know, we may not be offering value in our posts. So every time we post, we need to ask ourselves, what is this giving to the people who are watching it? Just not, I'm posting because I have to. So we want to make sure also that we use, I know I started using just Google pictures and saving them on my computer and posting them into my newsfeed. But a better way to do this is to create your own photo, get your own background, create your own background through all the apps that we have access to, with Canva, PicMonkey, or all the apps on your phone, and then write words down on that background, you know, a quote that you love and you want to share, or a picture of yourself and add a quote to that. Christine Dwyer said in her podcast that 45% of people unfollow us because of self-promotion, and 20% unfollow us because we're boring. So we want to make sure that we're creating good content. And I know that's so hard for me to do, and especially in the beginning. And I think that good content honestly comes from making sure you're doing your personal development and you're learning and growing as a leader and as a person in the health and fitness world. And that will create content for you to use on your social media platforms. That's what I'm trying to do, because I know it can get overwhelming, and you're just at a loss of what to post at times. So number two would be overuse of automation and lack of engagement. So, you know, Hootsuite and Post Planner and I think the Edgar, I haven't used that one ever before, but automation, you know, we don't want to be on autopilot. We want to kind of be there for a while we post and have engagement and like and comment on people who comment on our stuff. So, you know, we want to be around, and Facebook wants us to stay in their page for a while. So I loved the analogy that Christine Dwyer used, was that you're a party, you're at a party, and you are the host, and Facebook is your party, and you're the host. So let's say you're at this party, and you go up, and you're mingling with this group and that group of friends, and you go up, and you ask a question, and immediately walk away. that's what we're doing on Facebook. We ask a question, and if we don't, you know, converse in the next 15 minutes after that, it's almost like we've walked away. And that would be weird if we did that in person. So it's kind of weird to do it on Facebook. And she said that normally people who were questioned about what they expect from people who are running a brand or a business to respond, how the amount of time would be within an hour. So we want to make sure we at least go back and check, but kind of stick around too and hang out. So I think that's a great analogy in how we need to just be there and posting live and making sure we're engaged. Now, I love the Facebook like page because you can post directly, schedule your post directly from Facebook, and then it's not a third party tool where they might drop you a little bit on the newsfeed, from what I understand. So I love that option. So that's number two. Number three, they unfollow us because we post too much. So they may like hide us or unfollow, and Facebook pays attention to all of that stuff. What I learned while listening to this podcast was that Facebook, and even they everything we click on and watch, you know, they take credit for, or not credit, but they take notice of, and that's how they decide what to show us in our newsfeed. But even supposedly when we stop and pause and think about clicking on a movie or not, they are doing that as well, looking at that and taking that into consideration on what you might be interested in. So even if we don't click on it, but we kind of pause and wonder if we should or whatever, they monitor all of that. So, anyway, we might be posting too much information, and I guess that's just judged from what I understand on, you know, if you're posting 15 times a day and you have, you know, only a small amount of followers, then it might be a little too much. I can't even think of 15 things to post during the day, so that's crazy. But we just want to make sure we're not posting too much and you know, making sure, I would rather post too little with great content than post too much. And sometimes it's hard to find that line, I think. And it's just finding out who we are as business owners. So we want to make sure we have that quality, not quantity, so much so. So, what do our followers want to see? Our experts in the field of social media say that they want to see consistency. Even if it's one post a day, they want us to be consistent. So underneath how they want to follow us or why they want to follow us or what they want to see, put number one, consistency. A brand, they surveyed, I think they mentioned that at least one time a day they want to see. The statistics here on a survey said 68% of viewers for a brand post, people who are in business or branding, they want to see people post 1 to 2 times a day and not go post one day and go days without. 19% say that a brand should post with great content, if they have great content, should post 3 to 5 times a day. So how we measure this is by your like page and making sure we have one of those and looking at those analytics, because with your profile page, you can't see that stuff. Mary Smith says we can run our business from our profile page. That is not illegal. It's a rumor that's going around out there. But we also can't track the analytics. And in my mind, it's like if I'm running a business, a true business, then why wouldn't I want to have those analytics? So I almost want to be only on my Facebook like page, but they suggest running and building up both, of course, and not just abandoning ship. All right, so number two, for what they want to see is delivering quality content that is relative that to what you're about, your brand is about. They gather value from it, and maybe you have a great image. They want to see good quality image, which you can refer back to my last week's call or the week before, I can't remember, but I have a training that's very short. I mean, I'm not an expert at this stuff, but how I kind of get my pictures to pop and hopefully get people to stop scrolling. But we want to have great photos and videos. Don't want to have blurriness or, you know, just not not clear photos. But yes, so we want to have good quality content from what they see, hear, read. I know I'm horrible with typos. My husband texts me all the time after I do a post that is covered with typos, and I need to get better at that. Number three on what they want to see. They want to see stuff that they're interested in. And that's why we're trying to attract people who are like-minded to us. Obviously, if they're not interested in it, hopefully they just won't follow us. Number four, they want to feel special because you offered them a sneak peek. You're one of the first people to release this information, and they want to make sure that they go to your page or make sure they look at what you're posting because they know that you've got the ins, that you've got the information, and you can produce that info, that product first, and get them connected to whatever it is they're connected to you for, or they love, or your product, or whatever. But making sure that, you know, they feel special in whatever ways, with sneak peeks, rewards, prizes, stuff like that, is what they want to see. So I've got so many more notes, but it's just some information on what we can do to get our likes and our engagement up, which I'm working on myself, and it's just so, it's work. It's definitely work. So one, they suggest to us, and this is again from Christine Dwyer's podcast, they suggest for us to be human and not all about our product and our sell, but to be real, show our mistakes, show that we're not perfect, especially in our workout world. I think, and I've had people tell me this before, I am nowhere near close to my goal and I mess up all the time. And I feel as though I do share that, but I did have one person tell me that they thought that I worked out every day without fail. And I do fail at that sometimes. I do, because I'm human, and I realize I need to show that more often. But we need to show our errors and how we mess up. That's number one, be human to get our likes and our engagement up. Number two is to be funny. Everybody loves funny, and I don't know if I'm funny or not, but you know, try to be funny. Find something that's funny, a funny meme or a funny quote or something that happens in your life that, you know, could be a complete disaster, but you can turn it and make it funny instead. So be funny. Number three, show life events, your family stuff, big life events that may happen in your, like, my world, it's like birthdays and I don't know, parties at school, and shared, you know, when we've had our babies, you know, that big life events and just daily family events. That's one of my top five things about me. You know, I'm a stay-at-home mom, so I'm going to show family stuff. Number five, we want to be approachable and not stuck up, so full of ourselves. And we just, again, goes back to that being human. But yeah, we want to be approachable. We want people to be able to feel comfortable coming to us. I know that after I achieved Diamond, it was so awesome. I felt so good that a few people messaged me and just said, hey, I've worked out 3 times this week at the gym, and I just knew you would be excited for me. These are not my customers. Hopefully one day I'll be able to work with them. But I thought that was cool that hopefully I'm that approachable that they could do that, you know, and I hope other people feel that way too. So number six, that was number five, be approachable. Number six is be entertaining. Just be you and show the fun parts of your life. And of course we don't want to pretend that everything's all fun and games and we're perfect over here in this world, but we do want to show positive. I want to be a light in the world of darkness. So I'm not going to post a lot of negative stuff because then I'm going to attract negative comments and negative people. And I want to attract the inspiring positive people into my life. So yeah, things go wrong. But if I post something negative, quote unquote, on Facebook, I'm going to try to put a spin on it to how I can make it positive, because I want to attract positivity. I want to put light and positive vibes out into that Facebook world that is filled with so much negativity and mean people and mean things that happen in the world. So, you know, we want to be ourselves, be entertaining. Number seven is be consistent. I think that's like one of the biggest keys is just be consistent. Don't fall off the grid for a while, because then you're going to have to start all over again, and that's so hard. So how to have engagement increase? It's suggested to us to make sure we ask and stay, which we've already talked about. Stay around for a while, at least 15 minutes, they say, to interact and engage. Reply to all those comments that were under your picture. Like all of them, because all of that gets worked into the algorithms and tells Facebook you've got some good content there. Whenever people post and you post, it counts towards that. And hopefully you get seen in more people's news feed. From, you know, just researching and reading other articles about algorithms and stuff like that. I think I watched a video with Janelle Summers about Facebook 101 or something, if you want to look that up. It was very informational. But yeah, also we want to engage on other people's posts and their news feeds. So it's not just all about us. We want to like other people's stuff. We want to comment on their stuff and give real true comments where we're actually engaging in them and not just going through the motions. And we want to share other information or content if it's relevant to us, and not too much of the stuff that's not relevant to us. You know, stuff that's just going to be in our top five. You know, my top five are faith, family, fitness. I try to be funny. I don't think I am, but if I find something funny, I think people will laugh at, then I'll repost it and hopefully get, you know, some good stuff. But my husband, everybody thinks he's funny, so I love it when I can incorporate him into it. But we want to make sure that we are sharing things also that will help our business along. We don't want to share too much of someone else's coaching page, because we don't want them to go to them. You know, we want it to come to us. If they have a picture that we really like that we'd love to share, then why not recreate that scene for us if we have that kind of scene, like working out with babies and have a picture with your kids and working out. Don't share someone else's. Create your own content and then share that and attract people to you that way. They did suggest, and I think this is a great idea, to share your downline's information when promoting or highlighting ring advancement or successes that they've hit or goals that they've hit, because that's your downline. And in turn, that's going to help you too, because you are promoting a community where you are lifting someone up, one of your coaches, and hopefully they will be uplifted by that and want to help more people lose weight or start a business. So definitely want to do that. So I also looked at another article that kind of just said some things that I wanted to share, and then I'm going to wrap this up super quick. But in order to, we need to have very clear objectives for our social media. We want to have solid content strategy. So you need to come up with something you're going to post. You know, it's great to start off with Motivation Monday, Transformation Tuesday, Fit Tip Friday, you know, Success Saturday, Inspirational Sunday, whatever you can come up with. Have a content strategy. Have a promotional strategy where you know when you're going to post and how you're going to increase your fans and how you're going to just promote yourself, your challenge groups, how you're going to engage and respond to your fans and build a community. We need to have a conversion strategy where we turn our fans over into customers. And all of that just reminded me of why I create each month a calendar for us to know when we're starting. And we're a team. We need to all be on the same page and run this together. My groups are your groups until you can create enough people to have your own groups. But initially, we can just filter all your new customers into our challenge group, whether they have a challenge pack or not, and they just have a program. And from that group, we can then create people to plant seeds about Shakeology and then want to try it. And so all my groups are in our family page, our calendar, our marketing calendar, all that stuff I just said about strategies for solid content, promotion, engagement, and conversion is on that marketing calendar in our family page, pinned at the top. And that's what we need to go for. If you know you're talking to someone who wants to start a program, you look at that marketing calendar that you have already printed out and put on your desk, and say, we have a group starting on this date. You would love, I would love to have you by them. You've got to order by this time. Or, oh, you want to try Shakeology? Hey, we have a sample pack that you can try. And hey, let me enlighten you or give you information and educate you on what it is and what it isn't. And they can join our Shakeology 101 Next Steps group. That group is for you too, until you can run your own or feel comfortable running your own. That is what our marketing calendar is for. All right. So some other things that'll help us with our social media. One, we need to launch creative incentives, sharing prizes, maybe just what we can do to get people on board. Number two, post highly shareable content. We want people to like and share our stuff over and over again so that we get into those algorithms of Facebook and they say, oh, she's got good stuff, and they keep sharing it to other people and they can like it and hopefully share it as well and rank us higher on those algorithms. Number three, we need to build a tight community of real people who are our fans and our lifers, like Shirley Johnson says, that will want to support us, follow us, be with us, join us, and join this journey with us. Having a quirky brand, I think, is awesome. People who have just like a different twist on their brand. I created my own team logo, and I don't know if it's like the best out there. It has lots of meaning, and will it change in the future? I don't know. It's okay for me right now. It's grown on me a lot, but I just wanted something to create a brand and a community, and I'm going to do another video describing my team logo so that people know what it's all about, what I'm about, and so yeah. And number five, we want it to be a beloved person. We want to be, like we've already said, approachable, and we just don't want to be a big meanie. You know, we want to be ourselves so that we can attract like people, but we also want to make sure that we're not a big meanie. So I hope that these tips have helped you. I know that it was like jam-packed of information. I was like jotting notes down like crazy, 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 listening to Christine Dwyer's podcast. And of course, you can go and find that and get those details. I'm sure she explained things a lot better than I did, but I just thought that I would pass on that information in case you don't go and find her podcast or don't run across it or don't have time to go listen to it. Hopefully, you're listening to our team calls, because I am going out there and finding that stuff for us that I can share with you. So, with that and with my other information about the marketing calendar, please, please get on board with that. The top coaches are doing that. I kind of started it, and then I did a training where it spoke about how they were doing that, and I was on the right track with that, and I just had to tweak it a little bit after that training. So this will work. We just have to trust the process, and trust me that I am learning and training from the best of the best that I can, and I'm passing that information on to you, and I want to help lead you and guide you as well. So take that marketing calendar in our team Facebook page and use it, please. Thank you so much for taking the time to listen to this. It was a lot longer than I really hoped that it would be. So thank you, thank you, thank you. If you have found this and you are on another team, I wish you the best of luck in growing your business with your team. And if you are listening to this and somehow made it through all of this and you don't have a team, but you're wondering if my team would be a good fit for you, then please message me at coachlindsay.ali@gmail.com. I would love to chat with you and see if you would be a good fit and answer any questions that you may have about coaching and if it's really something that you want to do. So thanks again for listening and being here and taking those notes. It means nothing about taking notes and listening to stuff if we don't apply it. So I want to make sure that you apply all this stuff to your business and to what you're doing so that it will be meaningful and actually produce something for you. All right, y'all, I'm going to end here. Thanks so much. Have a great night. Bye.